Hello student, welcome to your chemistry lab. Today I am discussing chemical bonding. Here I will be discussing fourth part of chemical bonding, that is valence bond theory and VSEPR theory, that is valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. It is important for JEE and NEET and also board. So read very carefully. So now watching the whiteboard. Valence bond theory. The important postulate of valence bond theory are as follows. First point, a covalent bond is formed by the overlapping of atomic orbitals of valence shell of two atoms. Second point, the orbital containing unpaired electron can only participate in bonding and spin of the two electron must be opposite. Point 3. The greater extent of overlap, the stronger is the bond. Point 4. The bonds are formed in the direction in which the atomic orbitals are directed. The atom with half-filled atomic orbital must come closer to one another with their axis in proper directions for overlapping. The bonds are formed in the direction in which the atomic orbitals are directed. The imaginary line joining the two nuclei in a molecule is known as internuclear axis or molecular axis. Point 5. The maximum electron density in the overlapping orbitals is in between the nuclei of two atoms. The attractive force between this electron density and nuclei is the covalent bond. Point 6. Electrons which are already paired in valence shell can also participate in bonding if they are separated and excited to higher energy level of the same orbit. Point 7. The covalent bond formed with linear overlap of atomic orbitals along with internuclear axis is known as sigma bond. The covalent bond formed by the lateral overlap or sidewise overlap of two atomic orbitals perpendicular to internuclear axis is known as pi bond. Point 8. A sigma bond can exist independently, but a pi bond cannot. Pi bond will form only after the formation of sigma bond. Pi bond is weaker than sigma bond. Point 9. The shape of the molecules depends only on the sigma bond, but not on pi bond. Point 10. The overlapping atomic orbitals can only form a bond if they also have similar energy and similar symmetry. The strength of covalent bond is closely related to the extent of overlap of atomic orbital concerned. This is known as the principle of maximum overlap and it is extremely useful in the general consideration of covalent bonding in the molecules. Two s orbitals cannot overlap very strongly because of the spherical distribution of charge. What might be called an SS bond is therefore relatively weak because p orbitals are concentrated in a particular direction and because their lobes are longer than the radius of corresponding s orbital, they can overlap with other s or p orbitals more effectively than 2s orbital can overlap. Sp sigma bond are therefore stronger than ss bond and pp sigma bond are stronger still. It can be shown that the relative bond strength are of the order ss, sp, then pp. This is the difference in overlap between s 2s orbital and next one is 1s and 1p orbital. This is the following overlap with s and p and d orbitals are showing below. First, positive overlap are showing. Second, negative overlap are showing. Third, zero overlap are showing. VSEPR theory. Valence electron pair repulsion theory. The new theory we call following Gillespie's suggestion as the valence electron pair repulsion theory. This theory proposed that the stereochemistry of an atom in a molecule is determined primarily by the repulsive interaction amongst all the electron pairs in its valence shell. The theory assumes that the valence shell electrons occupy essentially localized orbitals specially oriented so as to maximize their average distance apart. The theory may be summarized as follows. First point, the shape of a molecule is determined by the arrangement and the repulsion between all of the electrons pair present in the valence shell of the central atom. Point 2. A lone pair electrons takes up more space around the central atom than the bond pair, since the lone pair is under the attraction of only one nucleus, while the bond pair is shared by two nuclei and drawn out between two opposite centers. It results that the repulsion between two lone pairs is greater than the repulsion between two bond pairs. Thus, the presence of lone pair on the central atom causes slightly distortion of the bond angle from the expected value. The repulsion are expected to increase in the order bond pair less than bond pair, less than lone pair means lone pair repulsion is more than the lone pair, than the bond pair. Point 3. The magnitude of repulsion between the bonding pairs of electron depends on the electronegativity difference between the central atom and other atoms bond with it. Point 4. Multiple bonds do not affect the gross stereochemistry of a molecule. The geometry of a molecule is determined primarily by the number of sigma bond pairs and the number of lone pairs. But electron pairs in double bond cause more repulsion than the one electron pair in single bond. And three electron pairs in triple bond cause more repulsion than the two electron pairs in double bond. Since the geometry of a molecule does not depend on the multiple bond, the two or three electron pairs of a multiple bond are treated as a single super pair. Point 5. Repulsion between the electron pairs in filled shell are greater than those between electron pairs in incomplete cell. Point 6. When an atom with filled valence shell and one or more lone pairs is bonded to an atom with an incomplete valence shell or valence shell that can become incomplete by electron shift, there is a tendency for the lone pair to be partially transferred from the filled to the unfilled cell. Point 7. In a valence cell containing 5 or 7 electrons pair in which all electron pairs cannot have the same number of nearest neighbors, those pair with the largest number of nearest neighbor will be located at a greater average distance from the nucleus than the other electrons pair. Prediction of geometry or shape of a covalent molecules. This table was discussed in previous class and today I will discuss using of VSEPR theory in BrF3. Here valence electron of bromine is 7, valence electron of fluorine is 7. We know that total number of valence electron equals to 28. First we are divide 8 for octet rule, that is the 3 bond paired electron, and remainder is 4. Next divide 2 for lone paired electron equals to 2 lone paired electrons. So bond pair plus lone paired equals to 3 plus 2 equals to 5, that is steric number is 5, that is the hybridization is sp3d structure trigonal bipyramidal. This is the first structure. Here lone pair are placed at axial position. We know that the repulsion of two lone pair or bond pair or bond pair or lone pair when 90 degree angle is present. Here lone pair repulsion is zero because two lone pair are placed at 180 degree angle, and lone pair bond pair, two lone pair are repulsion with three bond pair, that is equatorial bond. First lone pair is 3 and second lone pair is 3. So total lone pair bond pair interaction equals to 6. Here bond pair are equatorial at position, so here angle is 120 degree, so bond pair repulsion is 0. In this structure, two lone pair are placed at equatorial position. Here two lone pair repulsion is 0 because angle is 120 degree. We know that equatorial angle is 120 degree. And lone pair bond pair, here two bond pair are placed at axial position and one are placed at equatorial position. So first bond pair is repulsion with two equatorial lone pair, so interaction is 2, and second bond pair is repulsion with two equatorial lone pair and total interaction equals to 2. So total lone pair bond pair interaction equals to 4. Here one equatorial bond pair are present, so two axial bond pair are repulsion with bond pair equals to 2. And this is other structure. Here one lone pair place at equatorial position and one lone pair place at axial position. So here lone pair angle is 90 degree, so repulsion present is 1. And lone pair bond pair, here one axial lone pair repulsion with two bond pair electrons, so here two repulsion and one equatorial lone pair interaction with one axial bond pair, so total lone pair repulsion is 3. Here bond pair repulsion is 2. In this 3 structure, lone pair repulsion is present only this structure. So here the repulsion is maximum, so stability is minimum. So this structure we are not considerable. In these 2 structure, here lone pair repulsion is 0. We are see now bond pair repulsion. Here bond pair repulsion, first structure have 6, second structure have 4. So first structure repulsion is maximum, so stability is minimum. In second structure bond pair repulsion is minimum, so stability is maximum. So first structure are not considerable. So second structure, that is the T-shaped structure, are considerable. So this is the right structure. I think you are enjoying to watch my video. I think you are understanding all the points. If are not clear, so comment me, I will be replied you. If you are need to discuss any topics, please comment me, I will be discussing for you. So thank you everyone. Bye bye.